Let me begin. So this is my father. Dad, you could say your age, please.
I am 55 years old.
55 years old. And could you go ahead and tell us about the first memory that you could remember? And we'll go from there.
First memory that I've encountered as of age 8 years old, I moved to Milford, Connecticut, and lived off of 34 Davis Drive. And this is the memory of my first home, my first house that we truly were, that we owned. And it was kind of a special thing because we've always rented, and this was the first home that we actually owned. So really kind of neat. This was something that was actually, you know, in a subdivision. So we were around a lot of neighbors, a lot of good family type neighborhood. And a lot of special kids to be able to have fun with and enjoy. And I had a lot of interaction with a lot of different kids. Real special moment. We lived down the street from a really close to the beach area. It was more of like a swamp that led into the actual Atlanta. But it was really neat because we actually did build a lot of forts down there, and we did a lot of playing down there, and that was really kind of cool. So really, really, truly, that was one of the biggest things that I remember at age eight, and this was, like you say, in Milford, Connecticut. So, that was one of the biggest things that impacted me in my life as a young boy.
Yeah, cool. Don't you think it's, like, pretty interesting that, like, I know we kind of talked about it a little bit earlier, but it's, like, after so many years, you could still, like, remember, like, bits and pieces of, like, going back to, like, 8 years old. Like, it's pretty cool.
Yeah. It definitely was neat. This is something that was really, really special, and I think, you know, that at age eight, it was just something that it was such a drastic move for us from where we were at, because we lived in Stratford, Connecticut, which was about 2 hours to get to Milford. But I just remember because there were so many special things in moving into this home. And,
yeah,
you know, so it was really cool. We had a really good time. And it definitely, I think from that point on, from eight on, I just recalled everything from that point. We only spent about 5 years there in Milford, Connecticut, but that was such a great place to live and grow up in, and you know, until I was about 13 years old when I left and moved to California. So that's what really, where I always remembered every little bit of detail, you know, from that point. So great.
Like, how does memory work? How do you think you're able to remember something that's like so far back in your life?
To me, I just feel like big, huge impacts that happen. I think just to recall these special memories, I think it's just real special events that happen in your life. And
something that makes an impact.
Yeah, just a huge impact. And moving to this brand new home with a, you know, in a great place to live around a big subdivision that I never had. It just kind of everything, it just instilled in my head.
As a
young kid. And I think that to memories, I think things that really make a big impact for that, you remember these things, is because it was such a special moment in your life
that
you just don't forget, you know what I mean? And all of a sudden everything just kind of is there, you know? But yeah, it is kind of crazy how your mind works, and you know, how memories, you know, just stay there. Certain memories in your life will always be there with you.
Mm-hmm. It's kind of like part of your, sorry to interrupt.
Yeah.
I was going to say, it's kind of like part of your character development throughout your life. I guess like the memories you really hold on to are the ones that really make you who you are like today.
Yeah, no, I agree. I really do. I think, you know, it made me step outside my shell because, you know, I think I had to, you know, going into a new area, a new place, meeting new kids, it forces you to actually, you know, interact And so that gave me an opportunity to, in later life, to be able to push myself to interact with people. And it made me who I am today when, you know, because I've been in sales now for a lot of years.
Yeah.
So that helped me to, you know, to improve my overall sales abilities, you know, by my young childhood, by having that. So, yeah, it was huge.
All right. Cool. This up. But considering, you know, it's like a place, do you feel like it's the place that brings back the memory or like the landscape that creates the history of the memory? Oh, do you know what I mean by that? Yeah.
Yes. No, definitely. I agree with that. I think the memories of to where you're actually born and raised and that time, it just, those memories are easy to remember. So, I mean, those were special events back in that time, and being in the place I was at, you know, if I'm understanding it correctly, yeah, it's easy to remember those times because where I was at, you know, born and raised in Connecticut, was a special time in my place, you know, that I will always remember. You know, even to the age I am now at 55 years old, you know, I was 8 years old at the time living in that place, just brought up a lot of memories for me. And I don't think I'll ever forget, what happened at that time in my life, you know?
So, yeah. It's all very like, it's a special place for you.
Yeah. It's a special place. Exactly. So the memories will always be there, you know, until I leave this earth, you know?
Yeah.
So,
all right. Well, I think that's awesome. I think it'll be good to like conclude the video here. And thank you, Dad, for helping me out with this project and everything. And yeah,
sure. No problem. I was glad to do it. So I think these are great things and important things for you to have to do and start your career off in the special path you're taking. So I'm proud of you. So.
All right. Thank you.
You bet.